Hello everyone, as a part of our online classes, today we are going to discuss the topic from the nutrition. So we have finished the different many of the units from the nutrition. So today we will be discussing the unit 9, cooking rules and preservation of nutrients. Cooking rules and preservation of nutrients. So generally India, like our country, will having the different kind of the cultures, religions and the beliefs. So for each and every culture, for each and every religion, there is a different types of the foods will be consumed by the methods of their cooking, either according to the state wise, according to the religion wise, according to the country wise, there will be the different kinds of the foods or consume. It depends upon the climate or geographical surroundings or the such kind of the cultural practices. See, just cooking is an one of the art. If you are doing something work, they used to say that it is one of the art, it is one of the gifts. So here also the cooking is one of the art. So it includes, in India, then people will be having the different kinds of the state, culture, people. We used to see the different types of the cooking principles and the cooking activities, cooking methods. So by their religious style, by their economical style, by their country style, by their state style, they used to prepare different kind of the recipes according to their level. So here, before starting into the topic, we have to know what is the definition of cooking. Cooking is defined as the art or process by art, A-R-T, art or process by which the food is prepared by applying direct or indirect heat is called cooking. So here what we are doing, we are applying the heat or indirectly or indirectly method. So to prepare such kind of the food, so there should be a presence of the heat, or without presence of the heat also, we may cook the food materials. So here it is defined one kind of the art, and it is a process by cooking the different kind of the materials in the method of the heat or indirect or the direct method of the heat is called as a cooking. I note down the another definition of the cooking. It is the process of subjecting foods to the action of heat is termed as a cooking. So what we are doing here, we are doing it in an actionic manner. So the process of subjecting foods means here we all are mixing the different types of the vegetables or different types of the ingredients and making into one action, that is called as a cooking. So here, to begin a cooking for the good health, so not on generally to begin a cooking for the good health, we need such kind of the principles. See, principles of healthy cooking. Let's see what are the principles. So for each and every method, for each and every cooking or something program, there will be presence of the principle. So let's see what are the principles of healthy cooking. To begin the cooking for the good health, we have to revise and we have to think the meal pattern and shift our focus to those kind of the foods. If once we are regulated to that kind of the religion, or once we are regulated to that kind of the area or the pot. So see here, what are the principles? The basic principles of the healthy cooking are, first one is the select ingredients with the care. So what we have to do here, selection of the ingredients with the care, that is the must and should we have to focus. So here the how we can able to select the ingredients, so by designing of our menu. Either it may be including the small variety of ingredients or the large variety of ingredients. And then next one, high quality of the ingredients. So here whatever we are selecting the ingredients, that must be in a high quality, not in a low quality and not in a medium quality. Then next third, in selection of the ingredients only. So here the nutritionist will have to use the fresh and the seasonal vegetables, seasonal ingredients to produce or while preparing factoring in a menu planning when it is when the price is reasonable only, then they can able to select the ingredients. The high quality of the ingredients will be selected by the nutritionist. And then next one, non-traditional ingredients means non-traditional ingredients which will be providing the function and the flavor for the traditional items. Like if we are preparing something special dish, so here we for the flavors we used to add such kind of the ingredients like fat, high fat or the high sodium ingredients we must add. So that is the selection of the ingredients with the care. Then coming to the second one, store and prepare all foods with the aim of preserving their best possible flavor, texture, color and overall nutritional value. So here whatever we are selecting the ingredients here, so that must be with their best possible flavor should be there, and along with the texture and exact color should be there, and overall nutritional value, so how much the nutrition value will be provided for the these kind of the ingredients. So that must be provided by whatever we are the nutritionist is going to select the ingredients. So that is the second principle of healthy cooking. So here how we can able to select the flavor, texture and the color? By according to the temperature. So control temperatures carefully in receiving, like storing and the preparation and the servicing, like serving the food while serving or while preparing, while storing of the food. So we have to observe the temperature, we have to control the temperature of the room. And also like fundamental cooking techniques, the nutritionist who are going to prepare the one of the menu plan, they have to know the exact fundamental cooking techniques to ensure the quality of finished products. So here ensuring the quality of the finished products will be taken care by the person who are going to prepare the good meals for the people or for the community or for anyone. So this is the second principle that must be followed by the nutritionist. Then coming to the third one is incorporate a variety of plant-based dishes on the menu in all categories. So here the incorporate, like emphasizing towards the grains or the vegetables, we can able to shift the ingredients. Not only if we want to cook anything, only we doesn't use the ingredients, we may use the like grains, vegetables and the fruits. So by using these kind of the methods, all categories we can able to prepare the our dish. And also for to look the traditional activities or the ethnics. So like we can use the plant-based vegetables or the plant-based fruits. And the fourth one is the manage the amount of fat used both as an ingredient and as an part of preparation or cooking techniques. So here what not only selecting the all categories, and here also used for the optional for the unsaturated vegetable oils. So especially the person who are going to prepare the food, so they must be keep in mind that unsaturated vegetable oils whenever the possible, the reducing the using of the animal fats and also like animal products. So that must be controllable according to our diet, according to his or her menu plan diet. And use sometimes in some situations they are having the authority to use the fat soluble and also non-traditional low fat ingredients and the different kind of the low fat ingredients methods also they can able to use. So here by using the low fat methods, a low fat diet and the unsaturated fat, they can able to manage all the amount of the fat used both as well as the ingredients. And also the fat should be there, ingredients should be there, fruits and the vegetable should be there in the part of the preparation of our cooking techniques. And the next principle is serve appropriate portions of food. So here after preparing, the serving is the one of the most important principle. So here the serving should be according to the size of the portion. So here size of the portion means one of the good guider will be there for us. So he used to guide or she used to guide. So how much the size of the portion you have to divide it for the menu plan. So if they guide, so according to their guidance, we the nutritionist or the person who prepared the menu plan, they used to divide the or serve the appropriate limited portions of the food, and also not only serving and also monitoring the overall menu balance. So not only serving here, observing the overall menu balance, like individual menu balance items which will be established from the guidelines. So is there any mistake while serving, or is there any demerit while serving? So that should be observed by the guider and also the person who is going to serve. And also whatever the portions the person is going to serve, so that must be nutritionally balanced food. So if you are not at all preparing the nutritionally balanced food, so here you are not at all providing the quality of the healthy food to the person to whom you are going to serve. So here whatever the portions of the food, that must be nutritionally balanced. And the sixth one is the use salt with the care and purpose, because so some people will be habituated to take high taste of the salt. Some people will be habituated to the low taste of the salt. So here using salt with the care and the purpose means, so here like according to the seasons and the methods, preparation methods, to reduce the reliance of the salt, we can able to reduce the, according to our cooking method only we have to use the salt, according to our method, based upon the cooking method only we have to use the salt. Then that must be, whatever we are using the salt, that must be clean, and that must, the salt must be with the flavors, assertive flavors, and use the higher ingredients, sodium ingredients, sparingly to add flavors. So not rather than the salt, there are the different kind of the salt related flavors, so we can able to add them also. And also such kind of the, we can able to use this in the increasing the flavor. Why we are using the, so if we use the salt only, the food came, so food may get the such kind of the taste for the people or the person. So here the salt must be used with the, according to the care and the purposefully. So if you are using excess or if you are using the low, so it is not at all purposeful, and it is not at all nutritionally well balanced. And the seventh one is offer a variety of beverages, both alcoholic and the non-alcoholic. So here why offering of beverages means, so after generally in our programs or something occasions, or what our parents or the forefathers generally they used to offer it, like cool drinks, maza, milk shake, badam shake, sprite, thumbs up. So here those will be coming under the beverages. So here the both alcoholic and the non-alcoholic, why they are providing these kind of the beverages, mainly to special compliment for the our food menu. So these beverages make the menu as interesting, the good of the menu. So after completion of all menu planning, then at last if we give these kind of the beverages like cool drinks, maza, thumbs up or something else, so the people may give such kind of the compliment to our menu plan which we have planned for the food. So these are the principles that must be followed by the nutritionist or the people who are preparing the menu plan for the someone else or the community else. Then let's see the methods of cooking. So here the methods of cooking food can be various, the different types of the methods. You know what, the generally if I ask the question, what is the method of cooking, how many types of method of cooking means, you used to say many types: boiling, steaming, grinding, like cookering, pressure cookering, like microwave, oven, heating. So each and every person will be saying different kind of the answers. So here the generally methods of the cooking will be different kind of the methods. Let's see what are the methods in our nutrition, what are the methods are there. Let's see. So here there are the, especially the cooking methods are divided into three methods. The first one is the moist, and the second one is the dry, and the third one is the combination of both moist and dry. So here instead of moist, you can also write wet, moist or wet. So moist, there are the three methods of cooking methods. The first one is the moist, second one is the dry, and the third one is the combination of both, either moist and also dry. So let's see under the moist. So here the under the moist there are the six methods, and the dry there are the six methods, and the combination of both dry and the moist there are the three methods. See here, majorly the combination, the cooking methods were divided into the three methods. The first one is the moist, second one dry, third one is the combination of both moist and dry. So here, coming to the moist, again it is divided into the six methods, and also dry, again it is also divided into the six methods, and the combination of both moist and dry, it is divided into the three methods. So let's see what are the methods which will be coming under the moist. So here, the under the moist, the first one is the boiling, steaming, boiling, steaming, and the fourth one is the pressure cooking, poaching, blanching. Once again, I am repeating, there are the six methods which will be coming under the moist. First one is the boiling, and the second one is the steaming is different, and the steaming is different, don't be confused. Steaming, pressure cooking, fifth one poaching, sixth one blanching. These six will be coming under the moist cooking methods. And next one, dry cooking methods. So I already told that under dry cooking method, there are the six types. The first one is the roasting, second one is the toasting, and the third one is the grilling. Roasting, toasting, grilling, and the fourth one is the baking, fifth one is sorting, sixth one is frying. Got it? Then next one, combination of both moist and dry. So under these combination of both moist and the dry, the methods are divided into three methods. The first one is braising, second one is microwave cooking, and the third one is solar cooking. This is the methods of cooking. These are the methods of cooking. See, the methods of cooking were divided into three methods. The first one is the moist, and the second one is the dry, and the third one is the combination of both moist and dry. So under the moist, again it is divided into six methods. The first one is boiling, second one is steaming, and the third one is steaming, fourth one is pressure cooking, fifth one is poaching, sixth one is blanching. So, and coming to the dry method, roasting, toasting, grilling, baking, sorting, frying, and the last method, combination of moist and dry. So under the combination of moist and dry, so again it is divided into three methods. First one is braising, microwave cooking, and the third one is the solar cooking. Let's see one by one. So first one, so under the moist, so what is the first one? Boiling is the first one. So generally, you know, boiling means, so we used to boil many type of the vegetables. So here, boiling is one of the method of cooking of foods by immersing. So by immersing in water, if we want to take the boiled foods, so what we used to use the vegetables, immediately we used to immerse the vegetables in the water. So whatever the water, the temperature that must be at least, so here cooking in water at 100 degrees Celsius, under 100 degrees Celsius, or in coming to the foreign heat, 212 degrees foreign heat. So how much water should be heat? At least 100 degrees Celsius and 212 degrees foreign heat. So here we have to use, only the water must be according to these kind of the heat, that is called as a boiling. Generally, boiling is one of the method of the cooking different kind of the vegetables by immersing the vegetables in the water. So at how much degrees? Say how much degrees? 100 degrees. So and maintaining the water must be maintained according to the temperature when the food, whatever we are boil the food, that boil the boiled the food should be tender. So here what we used to boil, generally rice, egg, dal, carrots, roots, tubers, and meats. So these will be cooked by only boiling. Got it? So here the cooking in water at 100 degrees or 100 degrees Celsius or 212 degrees foreign heat is called as a boiling boiling. Okay, so here we can, by immersing into the whatever the vegetables should boil, that should be immersed in the water, then immediately we used to boil the food. So with different types of the food we used to boil, those are rice, egg, dal, meat, roots, tubers, and the like. Meat also we can able to cook by boiling. Then let's see the merits of boiling. So here already you know the different kind of the merits. Okay, so here the merits, so coming to the merits, it is a quick kind easy method of cooking, MOC, method of cooking. It is the easy quick process and also a easy process to cook a food. And then coming to the second one, simple method. It is a simple method, it does not require any special skill or the any equipment. And also here uniform cooking can be achieved. Means uniform cooking can means, so generally if you put carrot in one in same vessel, and also if you put something vegetable in same vessel, so the boiling will be same for all the vegetables. It should not be high or it should not be low. So by that uniform cooking can be achieved. These are the merits. Then coming to the demerits of boiling. So here the demerits of the boiling, nutrients dissolves into cooking liquids. Yes, we all know that. So if we boil any type of the food, so all the generally nutrients, all the nutrients will be dissolving in that water only. Then it is one of the demerit. If we lost the nutrients, then what we are eating, just general normal food we are taking. Then time consuming. Yes, it is a time consuming process. If you want to boil egg, means so it takes either 20 to 30 minutes. So it is a time consuming process. And here also we can able to loss, we can able to see the loss of color of the vegetables also, like water soluble pigments may be lost by boiling those kind of the food items or the vegetables. And here nutrients will be dissolving into the cooking liquids means, so here especially we are losing the nutrients, like nutrients such as vitamin B and vitamin C may loss in the water when the water is discarding. So if we are boiling the vegetables, so in that only the nutrients, vitamin C and the vitamin B will be losing in the water. These are the demerits of the boiling. Then coming to the second one, steaming. Second one is the steaming, not steaming, steaming. See here, steaming and simmering. Steaming and simmering is the same word. S-I-M-M-I-R-I-N-G, simmering. Okay, so here, cooking below the boiling point about 80 degrees to 90 degrees is called as a steaming. So if we cook below the boiling point, so what is the boiling point generally boiling, we have learned in the boiling only, so at least it should be there 100 degrees to 202 212 degrees Fahrenheit. So that is the general. So if we are cooking below the boiling point 85 degrees to 90 degrees Celsius is called as a steaming. Okay, so here steaming and simmering is also a same, steaming and simmering is also a same process. Like it refers the simmering of the food, means generally we used to cook the food, like food in a pan with tight fitting lid. We used to put one of the lid for that pan, so that lid should be in a tight fitting lid, like using a small quantities of the liquid may use to cover only half of the wood. So here the steaming means only covering the half of the food. So here this is the slow method of the cooking. The liquid is brought to boiling method, boiling point, the heat will be reduced to maintain simmering temperature. The food will be having above the liquid is cooked by the steam generated within the pan or within the lid, vessel lid. So here means half of the cooking means only here, only in the steaming, the half of the food will be cooked. Means why the half of the food is going to be cooked? Because it is having the below the point of the boiling point. point, that is the steaming. Let's see the merits of the steaming. So here the nutrients are the concern. So here nutrients, we can able to see here nutrients will be concerned because there is no wasting of water, there is no complete boiling, because half of the food is boiling, then immediately the water or something else that will be cooked with the, all the vegetables, then the nutrients will be saved and also flavor will be retained, and also loss of nutrients completely it will be avoided by these kind of the cooking, because there is no discarding of the water used. We can't able to use many more water, and if we are using little water also, the water which we have used that can't be discarded anymore. By that we can able to save the nutrients from the, we can able to preserve the nutrients from those kind of the vegetables. Then coming to the demerits of the steaming. So here it is the long and slow method of cooking. Yes, already I told that by way before telling the meaning of the steaming only, it is a slow method because it half of cooking, because by putting of a lid to the vessel, so we have to observe. By that it takes a lot of time. Long and slow method of cooking and time consuming process. It is also a time consuming process because, and also it takes a lots of time by, and it is also there is a wastage of fuel, means if you take lots of time to cook, there is a wastage of fuel. This is the merits and the demerits of the steaming. And the third one is the steaming. So generally we used to know that steaming foods, what are the steaming foods? Generally, what is our steaming food in breakfast? Idli. We used to see idli most of the time, it is a steaming food. Cooking by the heat of direct steam means if we take one of the whistle, if we pour some little water, and then we used to put the idli, like whatever the idli whatever we are taking the trays, so by that steam only the direct steam will be occurring. Cooking by the direct steam, the temperature is attained higher than the 100 degrees. So here by the cooking vegetable, whatever the vegetables have to cook, that will be cooked by the direct steaming. It is a method of the cooking food in a steaming, generated from the boiling water in a pan or such kind of the vessel. The food which is to be steamed, that will be placed in a container, like a idli container, okay, and it is not in a direct contact with the water or liquid. Have you observed that idli container? If you are preparing the idli container, just you go and observe, the water is very, very separate and the lids will be separate. It is not at all direct contact with the water. So example, I am using the example idli vessel only. So here some of the vegetables also we can able to steam. So here what here steaming, like momos are steaming. To prepare the different kind of the food items also by steaming methods also they can able to prepare. So here in this picture, these are the momos. It is a North Indian food, so by most of the people will be habituated to eat this kind of the food. So by generally they used to prepare with the either with the maida flour or wheat flour, we can use anything. So here under these we will see here, I have you observing the holes. So by the under that there is a water, so steaming will be raising. By that steaming these momos will be cooked. Then let's see the merits of steaming. Flavors remain in the food. Yes, so here flavors will be always remaining in the food, and also food cooked by this method is easily digested. Why? Because so already it is like cooked vegetables we used to put in different. So if we are taking the momos or something else like idli, as I told that example of the idli, food cooked by this method is easily digested. So if the idli is easily digestible food or hardy digestible food, it is a easy digestible food, and that the texture of that food will be easier, light and the fluffy. See, just go and observe when your mother or when someone else is preparing, just you observe. And here also the food cooking time will be taking the time of the food is a less, and the nutrient loss is a very minimized. These are the merits of the steaming. Then coming to the demerits. So here the demerits, steaming equipment is required. Yes, so without the equipment we can't able to perform the we can't able to prepare the food. And the second one is, this method is limited to prepare the preparation of selected foods only. So if we want to make the dosa, we can able to steam? No. So here it is only limited to the preparation of the selected food items, not only the for each and every food it is not at all used. So that is also one of the demerits. Then let's see the fourth one is the pressure cooking. So our daily mother will be using for different type of the food items, or the pressure cooker will be using for the dal and for the meat. So here some people will be using this cooker for the rice also. Okay, so here this is a method of cooking food by steam under pressure. Foods is cooked in a pressure cooker 100 degrees to 112 degrees Celsius. Okay, here centigrade. Okay, this is your method of cooking food by steam under pressure. Foods is cooked in a pressure cooker completely. Here food will be cooked by the steam under pressure. So here the foods will be cooking only under the pressure of above the degree should be at least 100 to 112 degrees. Okay, let's see the merits. You know that where pressure cooking, when steam under pressure is used, method is known as a pressure cooker, and the equipment will be used in the pressure cooker only. Equipment, what is the equipment used to prepare the food in the pressure cooking? So pressure cooker only. In this method, the temperature of the boiling water, that should be raised above. And here, what are the food materials we can able to cook in the pressure cooker? Like rice, dal, meat, roots, tubers. So these will be used in the preparation of the pressure cooker. Let's see the merits. So here the it saves time and energy. Yes, it saves the time and energy, and also it little loss of nutrients. We can able to see sometimes it overflows. So by that little loss of the nutrients and the less chance of burning. So less chance of burning means, so just we are not at all always touching the vessel, because once we used to on the stove and we used to put on the stove, then after 20 minutes or after 15 minutes, then we used to off the stove. So there is a less chance of the burning. That is also one of the merit for the preparation of the cooking method. Then coming to the demerits, danger of overcooking food. So see here, many of newses or many of information we used to hear that, so someone house there is a problem of the pressure cooker due to the overheating or the overcooking. So here sometimes it may raise the, it is also one of the dangers for the overcooking of the food items. And here the needs constant attention. Yes, it is also one of the demerit. So if we put the cooker on the stove, we should not move here and there. We have to focus on the particular type of the preparing the food items. If you put the, it is also, if you put on the stove, we can able to work, it is a easy process. We can able to perform another work, it is a easy process. If you want to maintain a constant attention, means it takes very horrible situation for the person, those who are preparing the food. Then coming to the fifth one is the poaching. Egg poaching. Have you heard the word poaching of the egg? So here the cooking in the minimum amount of the liquid temperature, temperature 80 to 85 degrees, that is below the boiling point. So here below the boiling point, generally the boiling point is the 100 degrees. Okay, so here the poaching will be performed at the below the boiling point. So here the egg poaching, generally egg fish can be poached here. See here, this is the egg poaching only. Just they used to off boil, like they used to cook in a off boil, and they used to cook in the pan or something vessel itself. Then merits of poaching. So here the no special equipment is needed. There is no special equipment is needed. Either we can able to use the pan or the vessel. And the second one is the quick method of cooking. It is the one of the quick method because of boiling. It will be cooked immediately. Just if we want to take the prepare such kind of the poaching methods, we can able to try in preparing of the omelette. So if we put it in a pan, then I immediately, if it is off cook, then immediately the poaching, just adding something ingredient, then immediately we can able to eat. Quick method of the cooking, then variety of the liquids can be used, so different kind of the liquids. So he see here different kind of the liquids, so whatever the poached egg or the poached fish, we can able to use different kind of the liquids can be used. That is those are the merits of the poaching. Then coming to the demerits of the poaching, range of suitable foods only limited. So here the range of suitable foods means, as I told that fish or egg, as either if you want to poach, so you have to poach only the egg or the fish, means limited suitable foods is a limited, and the poached foods may not be appeal to everybody. So here, because they will be the bland in taste, there is the taste of those poached poached food is a bland taste. So because it due to that bland taste, the people, some people will be not appeal for their body or their condition. So here, well, that is also one of the demerit. And also water soluble nutrients may be leached into the water, and food can be scorched if water evaporates due to the careless of the monitoring. These are the demerits of the poaching. And the last and the final one is the blanching. So here, blanching, you know that blanching, so boiling of tomatoes or something else, so like peeling the process of subjecting foods into the boiling temperature for short period is known as a blanching. Whatever the foods like tomatoes, or if you want to peel something else, potatoes, that is the blanching method. So subjecting foods into boiling temperature for a short period, it doesn't take the long period of the time, that is called as a blanching. Generally in meal preparation, in our meal preparation, it is necessary only to peel off the skin of the fruits and the vegetables without making them any tenderness. So this can be achieved by the only method of the blanching. So in this method, the food, whatever the fruits or the vegetables, that will be dipped in boiling water for 5 seconds to the 2 minutes, depending upon the texture of our food items. So by dipping the water, that will be helps to remove the skin or peel without softening the food items. Blanching will be done by the pouring enough boiling water, so on the food, to immerse it, like for some time, subjecting the foods to boiling temperature for the short duration and the short periods. Then immediately that will be immersed into the cold water. The process that causes the skin to become loose and that can be peeled off easily. So here, got it. So whatever the process I told, so first we have to take the boiling water, then immediately, so after first we have to dip the vegetables into that boiling water, then after that, so that completion of the short period of time, then immediately we have to immerse the vegetables in the cold water, then easily we can able to peel the skin of the vegetables. So that is the blanching. Then let's see the merits of the blanching. So here the peels can easily be removed to improve digestibility. Generally we used to eat any fruit or the vegetables, so before eating or before intaking we used to peel, so that will make us easily digestibility and destroys enzymes, so which will be brings about the spoilages. And here the texture will be also maintained while improving the color and the flavor of the food. So these are the merits of the blanching. Then coming to the demerits of the blanching, so here the loss of nutrients if cooking water is discarded. So when we are discarding the water, so by that water only the important nutrients will be losing. And also blanching cannot be used for every type of the food item. So here the blanching, for each and every food item we can't able to use the method of the blanching. Only few types of the food items only we can able to use the blanching methods. So these are the moist methods of the cooking methods. Got it? So under the moist method, there are the 6 methods. The first one is the, what are the first one? First one is the boiling. Second one is the Steaming, and the third one is the steaming, and the fourth one is the pressure cooking, and the fifth one is the poaching, and the sixth one is the blanching. So these are the methods of the cooking which will be coming under the moist cooking method. Okay, next class we will be discussing the dry methods of cooking. So under the dry methods of the cooking also, again there are the six methods, and again the combination of the both dry and the moist, there will be divided into the three methods. So in next class we used to learn about the dry method of the cookings. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you everyone.